In today's video, I'd like to share my experience with the issue I had with the flash drive of the Garmin Approach S2J. But rather than going straight to the troubleshooting, let me bring you through the different reset and service mode of the watch. With a softer reset, you can basically get out of any frozen screen without losing any setting. Simply hold the light button until the watch turns off. Then restart the watch. The master reset will bring back the watch to the factory default setting. It does not erase data from the flash drive, but it resets the user setting to the factory default. It will also create a Garmin folder with a Garmin device.xml file if those are missing. We will see this a little bit more in detail later. Since on the S2J the default language is Japanese, I'm accessing the setup menu to change the language back to English. As far as time is concerned, you can either adjust it manually or automatically. If you choose automatic, the watch will need to access the satellite signal to adjust the time. It will then use a file located on the flash drive to adjust the hour to the proper time zone. The service menu provides some insight on the watch, software version, time since last master reset, the ROM and the RAM condition. For this you have to wait for the result of the test. The golf course map checksum. And here you can load up to 4 regions, but the size of the drive on the S2J is only sufficient for 3. So one of the region is failing the test, but this is completely normal, just because the file is missing on the drive. And finally, you can test the LCD screen condition and buttons. This mod is to force the flash drive to mount as a USB drive in case the PC does not recognize the drive. Place the watch in the cradle, hold the up button and plug the USB cable in the PC USB port. And remember to always eject the flash drive when you are done before disconnecting the USB cable. Since my watch was locating satellite properly but not updating to the proper time zone, and the checksum of the region was failing, I narrow down the issue to the watch not reading or accessing properly the information located on the flash drive. So I decided to reformat the flash drive and this is the process I'm gonna share with you now. Do this at your own risk. It worked for me, but it might not be a cure for all type of issues. I also received a disclaimer from Garmin that I'm sharing with you. This is the content on the flash drive. Scorecardviewer.html and the Garmin folder will be recreated automatically after the master reset if they are not existing yet on the flash drive. The Gmaptool.img is the file for the time zone and that indicates the watch, the correct hour for the region. The Garmin device.xml will allow Garmin Express to detect the flash drive and to do the update. Without this file, the Garmin Express will not recognize the drive and the watch model. The remaining file are the golf course maps. Inside the Garmin device.xml, you can find information such as the hardware ID, you know, the 4 digits after the B, and here it's 1891, the software version and the watch model. I tried different software to format the flash drive, including DOS, Windows, Partition Magic, but the watch would still not read the drive. I finally succeed using RMPRepUSB. All the links in the description. I followed the instructions provided in the post and reformatted my flash drive. The flash drive was then completely empty, and after disconnecting the watch and performing a master reset, all the minimum files were again present on the drive. The scorecardviewer.html and the Garmin directory with the Garmin device.xml. I believe those files and this directory are automatically recreated by the watch when doing a master reset in case they are not present on the flash drive. All I had to do next was to connect the watch to the Garmin Express so that I could perform the necessary update for the time zone and all the golf course. After locating the satellite, the time was now in the proper time zone and all the course checksum were okay. The watch was again in perfect working condition, problem was solved. During the course of event, I did also update the firmware, though I believe it was not necessary in my case. First, you need to find the firmware corresponding to your model. All the links are in the description. Then, to flash the firmware, use Garmin Cure3.exe in administrator mode. Locate the firmware and check that the hardware ID is identical to your model. Then start updater, choose the USB device and plug the watch in preboot mode. Wait for updater to detect the watch and proceed with the flash. All these issues started with a weak battery that I have since replaced. You will find in the description a link to a video explaining how to replace the battery. On the left, the original battery, and on the right, a 402530 battery of 300 mAh, which is 50% higher capacity than the one recommended on the video or the original battery. To keep your battery as healthy as possible, do not overcharge and avoid complete discharge. About 3 hours plug on the PC should be enough to recharge your battery. I was able to repair my watch. If you came here because you're having an issue with your Garmin Approach, I hope this tutorial will be helpful for you. In today's video, I'd like to share my experience